Good afternoon from Birkenhead War Memorial Park. This is Peter Vogue of Pete's Filming, bringing you the coverage of the Fox Memorial Qualifiers Round 2 game between Northgate Tigers and Glenora Bears. These two teams both without a win in this three-week competition, because it's 3 weeks. After the 3 weeks, the bottom one drops out of each section, the four. And so they're both going real hard for it today. The referee today's game is Brent Newton. Touch judges are Lee Fletcher and Warren Clark. So we'll be back in a moment for a well-fought game. Yeah, back again. I've just got Solomon here, the captain of the Glenora side, to just tell us how the team is going or hasn't been performing. How's it going anyway?
Yeah, obviously we went down last week. I think it was a bit of a wake-up call for the boys. Just you could expect whatever comes into the air all these days. So, the boys have been travelling good. We had a good training week this week, and they seem to have their heads screwed on today, and hopefully we can get the 2 points against Norfolk.
That's really good, Solomon. You know, it'll be a hard-fought game today by both sides, because both of you have got no points, and waiting for next week. Who have you got next week?
I think we've got Marist at home.
You've got Marist at home, so, you know, who knows what it's going to be like, you know. So I appreciate your time coming across for the interview, and good luck for the game.
Cheers.
Thanks, Solomon. Okay. Ciao. We're back here for the game. Yeah, Northgate decided to come out, holding the Glenora players waiting, and Mr. Brent Newton. And it was good to have Solomon, the captain of the Glenora side, here with me today to interview him. Northgate, because I'd said no for a start, but never mind. We're doing the toss now, Northgate tossing, and Phil Kingy will call.
Heads it is. As you are, kicking or receiving. So beautiful, we're kicking this way. Gentlemen, listen to my action commands. It means your tackle's complete and I want movement. Accuracy and contact. Other than that, have a great game. We're kicking this way, gentlemen.
So Glenora to kick off from right to left. So as I said before, this game very important for both these teams. Neither of them have got a win after last week's game, and it was only three games in this series, which is a qualifying round, and they need to win at least one, I think. Who knows? We'll see after today's game.
Are you going right?
I know that Glenora next week have got Marist, and I'm not sure who Northgate's got, so we'll get underway with the music stops, and the referee blows time on.
No release, boys. Northgate, you ready? Houston, you sweet? Time you're on!
Underway now with Glenora kicking off, and it's going to be it's Morgan Cook with the, or is it Hiram Meyer?
Contact's
who takes
good.
The ball up, takes the catch, and sends that
14!
Prop
stand
through. And,
no, he's milking!
Go. Northgate up and play the ball, and they're bringing out to that left-hand side. That was Morton that took the ball out there. And that's Tafiti, Sio Tafiti, take that head up for Northgate. They're just short of the, 15 metres short of the halfway line. And another run, take it up about 8-9 metres short of the halfway line. Go out to the right-hand side. Kevin Locke to kick down to the southern end of the park, and come away with the fullback Galton. Galton's brought down 28 metres out from his own line. They'll get up and play the ball. They'll take it to the centre of the park. Some of the players struggling to get back on side from the Glenora team there, but I know it's very hot here at Birkenhead War Memorial Park. Kingy in the dummy half gets out to Kavaluku. Kavaluku takes it up. He's a force to be reckoned with. He's been around for a few years and he knows what to do, and a good player, real gentleman. 11 it is with the ball. That's Farmani. Farmani takes the ball up towards the halfway line. Comes away to the left-hand side to Philip King. Takes it away to Kavaliko again. He passes it back to Hiramaya. Hiramaya for Northcote. Lock into dummy half for Northcote. Glenora penalised there. Taking a little bit long to come off for the referee Newton.
Bring it up.
A bit of a crowd here for in a wet day, not a very good day to come watch footy. But Locke takes the ball at the middle of the park, gets it out to Hiramaya. Hiramaya takes it 12 or 13 metres inside the Glenora half. They're on attack now, first real time. Out, big number 10 comes through, and that's Tafiti. He get up and play the ball. Goes left hand side. Goes out to Drag. Caught there. I think it's high, as it, Mr. Newton says. Yes, it's high tackle on the on Drag. So they've taken a quick tack. But a little bit of a sneaky one there. Number 13 with the ball. Holloway, Houston Holloway, the captain for Northcote, who we were going to interview, but because I called it off, he didn't come out. So didn't mind. Good old Solomon came and did it anyway for the Glenora side. So Northcote, number 9 to dummy half, is sending out Sione Tali. Gets it out on the left-hand side, and a drop passed out there. Glenora come away with that. Northcote inside the 10. The referee Newton penalises. Oka kicks the ball into touch. Good long kick down that right-hand touchline. 8 metres inside the Northcote half. And it's Brown with the ball. Chaz Brown. He'll flick it out to his left-hand side. They come away to Vakai. Vakai takes it inside the 40 there. Glenora on attack. Comes out to their loose forward. Goes out to Cavaluku. He's already been involved in about three, four times now. So looking on his ability and his strength and his knowledge. And Kingy getting the ball out to Galton. Galton, the fullback there. And in the back play, something happened there. So it's like they tripped over each other, whatever. Comes away, number 13 with the ball now. And he's going towards the line. That's Nathan, Robbie Nathan. And he loses the ball, come away with it. The halfback is Locke, Kevin Locke, and it's going to be a callback for the knock on there. So Northcote will come away with the scrum feed there. Been raining most of the day here at Birkenhead Memorial Park, you know, but good weather for the players to play under. Ground's in excellent condition through the council or through Landscape Solutions, I think, are the people that look after this ground and have made a good job. So Northcote to feed the scrum, and it'll be Drag, Nikki Drag, to feed the scrum for Northcote. They go right-hand side, and Kevin Locke robbing in his ankle. There were too many practice kicks and just before the game in the practice, I think, maybe. Northcote come away with the ball. They're going to be dragged over towards the sideline there. Got to be a little bit careful when they drag players into touch or towards touch. Northcote bringing it up. They bring it up to the about 27 metres out from their own line. They go up the middle. A big boy coming up, running on a 10. That's Tafiti, Sio Tafiti. Into dummy half goes Saloni. Sione Tali, they go out to the left-hand side. Northcote spreading it wide, getting out to their centres out there. 5 metres short of the halfway now. They come away with the ball, Locke with the ball now. And they put a high up and under there. And who's going to be game enough to take it? Nobody takes the ball. And Glenora, winger, right winger there, Wickman takes the ball. Maxwell Wickman takes the ball. Nice, he stands back and says, I'll take it for you. And Galton comes in with the ball for Glenora, takes it up to the 40. They come left-hand side again. Comes away with Wickman. Wickman takes it over the halfway line. Glenora now putting themselves on attack. Kicking into the back line now. Gets it into his Faimani. Faimani takes it over the 40-metre mark. Misses the ball there. Referee missed that. Goes away now, and it's Nathan with the ball for Glenora. He gets up and plays the ball. King into dummy half to clean up, and it's Ioka puts a bomb kick up. The bomb kick hits the ground. comes up over the top, and I think it's number six. It's Ioka. I think he's the kicker of the ball. Goes up, follows through, and a lucky bounce there, and he gets the ball down to the ground. Good kick through. Nobody seemed to want it from Northcote in the in goal area. They would let it bounce first, and it bounced up pinpoint for Ioka there to score the first points of the game. So 7 1/4 minutes gone here at Birkenhead War Memorial Park, and Glenora, the visitors, taking first advantage of that kick through the air, and coming away with the four points. So it's Ioka to convert. He does, and it's over. So 6-0 after 8 minutes gone here at Birkenhead Memorial Park in this Fox Memorial Qualifiers game, round two. Remembering that the winner of this, as I said, Glenora's got Maris next week, and you know, Maris beat Northcote last week, so who knows, in a game of footy, you take it on the day. And so the loser of these two must win next week, so otherwise they'll end up in Sharman Cup. Kickoff being made by Kevin Locke. High in the air, looking for the thing, and he knocks it forward. So Glenora come away with it there. Good attempt by Kevin Locke to put the ball in a gap there, but his man coming through couldn't take that ball and lose it. So I think he's going back. He's going to the knock on by Northcote, and Glenora will have the feed. So 9 minutes gone here at Birkenhead War Memorial Park. Score at 6-0. Ball goes in and out. It comes out their left-hand side. That's 11 with the ball. It's a Faimani. Faimani will get up and play the ball on the 40. It's the hooker, Agatia. Agatia will take the ball up to the 8 metres inside, and Kavaliku takes the ball up a metre short of the halfway line. He'll get up and play the ball. He'll run all day and just barge through the defensive teams, and there's going to be a penalty there for a inside. Oh no, it's a tackle without the ball. The player who did it knows he did it. This number 8, I think it was, and Kio. Okay, to kick the ball down to touch down the club room side of the ground. Good long kick. Fully advertised here for Northcote Tigers. They come away with it now, and it's Vakai. Vakai takes it towards the post. They bring it out to the left-hand side. Goes it to Nathan. Nathan is brought down inside the 10 now. Kavaluka goes through the line. Can he get through? He loses the ball forward. They're going to run it out, are they? Any advantage there? Referee says yes. So Northcote come away down that, let down out the left-hand side there. I thought he was a bit of a truck, and they tried to truck and trailer him. Northcote come away with the ball now. They bring it up to past the 20-metre mark. Come out right hand side. Houston Holloway with the ball. Captain leading by example, was he? Yes. Comes out. Comes out to the centre. Phil King, will he miss it? No. Good tackle by Phil King. He doesn't miss many tackles in his game. Very dedicated player, Phil. Goes out the left-hand side to Kevin Locke. Kevin Locke puts a long little grubber kick down to that touchline there, but 5 takes it nice and easy. That's vacant. He takes the ball up and he's tackled there. So some good play down the side. Good tackle by Phil Kingy. And then they put the kick away. Locke put it down, but comes out. Chaz Brown gets it away now to the Gorton. Gorton comes away now towards the 40-metre mark. They come away again, and Kingy with a ball inside pass to Kavaliku. Kavaliku takes the ball up. He's working really hard. So comes away now, comes out to Devlin. Devlin's taking the tackle there inside the 40 into dummy half, goes Viamone. Viamone gets it out to Kingy. Kingy down to the right hand side, gets it. Kavaliku again having a go. It's two hit uppers in the set of six already for him. He loves his game of footy. He loves taking the ball up. Goes to the right hand side now to Ioka. Ioka kicks it high in the air, and it's going to be taken nicely by McCarthy this time. He got up and took the ball where they stood back last couple of times and didn't bother with it, but that's a nice take by Hemi McCarthy for Northcote. They come right hand side again. So Northcote trying to bring it away from their own half. Goes out the left hand side to Dragon, and he offloads it to his bigger boy coming through, and he takes a tackle. They go left again. They're going up the middle by the away. Kevin Locke into dummy half position, kicks the ball on the full. It goes a long kick, but it still hit the outline. So it's a handover to Glenora. 15 metres inside the Northcote half. 14 minutes gone here at Birkenhead Warren Park with the score at 6-0 to the to the visitors, Glenora. Tell you a little story about that. I started playing rugby league when I was 5, and Glenora was the first team I played for, and I transferred when I was 10, came across to Northcote and played until I was 26. So a couple of good clubs, must be. General Kavaliku gets up with the ball again. They go again, and Gorton comes away, the fullback, exciting little fullback he is. He steps off his left and right foot. He's taken inside the 20 now, and it's a little run through by the hooker, Van Gupo. Van Gupo, there it is. Comes away to Nathan. Nathan out to Oka, and the ball goes dead. It's taken dead, I think it is, by yes, it is taken dead by the Nikau Drag for Northcote. So another goal line dropout. Pressure telling on Northcote at this stage. I've seen a lot of players move around in the Fox club sides, going from one club to the other, and couple of guys out going overseas from a couple of the clubs, which is, it's good, gives them a chance to go over and play some top footy over there. Whether they make it or not, it's up to them. It comes away now, it's Ioka with the ball, takes it inside the 30. They come away again, and it's Vakai. Vakai takes it up the middle of the reserve, player 14. He takes it towards the middle of the park. Into dummy half goes Van Gupo. Van Gupo takes it out to Kavaliku. Kavaliku takes the ball, twists and turns, going again, looking for that try line. Still can't quite get there. Arm wasn't long enough. They come right again. Kingy out to the right-hand side there. Put it away, and who's going to pick it up? No, it's knocked on by Northcote. So it must have been knocked out by Northcote. So it'll be a scrum. Orlando, we'll soon see. It's going to be a scrum. It's going to be a Glenora feed. So 16 minutes gone here at Birkenhead Warren Park in this Fox qualifier round two game. The away side leading by 6 points to nil. So you put it into the scrum and literally. Just waiting on the halfback to not the halfback at all. Comes away, there's Phil King there. Out to Galton. Galton goes away with it. Easy to recognise with that headset he wears. They go right again, and it's Viamani comes towards the post, and into dummy half goes Van Gupo gives it away. No, he doesn't. He goes towards the try line. He bounces, and he's bounced short. Into dummy half goes Viamani. Viamani comes away, and it goes out to Nathan. Nathan trying to barge his way through the line. He's had three attempts now and one drop. So this time he hangs on to it. Van Gupo takes the ball up. Goes out to Ioka. Goes out to Chaz Brown. Chaz Brown going to the corner. Can he get over there? He's quite strong. No, he's into touch. Referee, touch judge says he's gone into touch. And looking at Chaz's face, he knows he went into touch there with good tackle. I think he's telling the players, give it to me earlier. Perhaps. Who knows? So come on, it's a handover to Northcote, but Northcote's struggling at the moment because Glenroy are putting a lot of pressure down that end of the park, so they need to get themselves down the other end of the park. That's where you score tries. And a penalty against the big boy there. I got you. Kicked into touch just short of the halfway line there. Mr. Warren Clark on the touch side there. It's Haku. Haku with the ball. Gets it out to Tafiti. Tafiti goes to the ball, but hard tackle on him, and he didn't have the security of the ball. He lets it go. Tried to use the ball as a battering ram, and it didn't go come off. So he's... giving the ball away once again to Glenora. So if they keep giving the ball away to Glenora, Glenora's going to do some points with it, you know, something with it. You've got to use your possession when you've got it. Coach of the Fairman on the sideline. Glenora bring out the left-hand side. Chaz Brown takes it up through, takes it over the halfway line, takes it 9 metres inside the Northcote half. Kevin Locke's got his number, and away we go. Phil Kingy with the ball, gets it out to his left-hand side. Taken down there is Fomani. Fomani will play the ball. It goes out to the, and it's a Van Gupu was it, gives it out to his other man, and no, he didn't get it. He didn't get it out to his, Nathan with the ball now, throws a pass into number 14, Vakai. Vakai takes it towards the post, and he's brought down. 20 minutes gone coming up now. Number 8 with the ball now. That's Igatia. Igatia going towards the line. Last tackle called by the referee. Can they get over in that corner? Number 12 with the ball. He's taken onto his back. A good tackle there by number 4, Haku. Oh, and they do silly mistakes. That's just a basic mistake you don't do. You look at the ball, you put your hands on the ball, and you pick it up. It's easy for you to say here, Pete. You're just a commentator. So they're shooting themselves in the foot, Northcote, by the possession they're giving away. And when they make silly mistakes like that, it just makes it very hard to the rest of the team to come back. Van Gupo with the ball now, out to Kingy. Kingy goes out to his left-hand side to Galton. Galton is brought down. They go right-hand side to Agatia. Agatia's tackled in front of the post there. They go right-hand. Van Gupo puts it out to his right-hand side, goes out to Galton. Galton out to Chaz Brown. This time he says, I'll have a go, and he flicks it on to Galton again. Galton has another go. He's going towards the line. He tries to give it away there, and did he lose it? Lost it into the Northcote player, I think, and looking like he was going to play the throw a pass, and he put it into the Northcote player, which constitutes a knock-on. So he'll learn from that mistake. He's a good little fullback. Sure, he played for Howick. Who knows? Find out later. Northcote with the ball now. What can they do with it? Lock with the ball. Comes out. They go a couple of dummy passes there. Get up and play the ball. Northlake trying to bring it out of their own 20 now. Shane Talia into dummy half for Northgate. Takes it out to his left hand side. Gets away to Talia Kay. Tighty. Little chip over the cop, and who's going to get the bounce of the ball? Is it going? Oh, and another kick through. Chasing it through is number six. It's Drag, and Drag catches it nicely there. So a good 70 metre run. Play there by Northcote, maybe 60 metres, but certainly I do. And Glenora getting up now, and some of their players walking back through the defensive line there of Northcote, because it is hot, very, very hot here at Birkenhead Warren Park. Nathan with the ball for Glenora, making a good siege of it now. Comes in inside the 40 metre mark, yeah, picked up by Phil Keeney nicely. He's put a little grubber kick for him, and who's going to pick it up? The Northcote player. Well picked up, dumped in the process, but he did his job. That's what it's about. Lock into dummy half, gets it away to left hand side to Tali Kai. Tali Kai is going to get a penalty out of that. By Marnie. So using that other arm. Down on the player, so. Northcote get a penalty, which is they sort of need a few at the stage. They're playing at the wrong end of the park to win a game of footy. So 24 minutes gone here at Birkenhead War Memorial Park in this Fox Memorial Qualifiers Round 2 game. Of course, the visitors, Glenora, are leading by 6-0. It was Cook that passed the ball out there, and Phil King hits the bigger man. There. Says, you know, I can tackle too. He goes in, he's not scared. Not much else, Phil, but he's there all the time. They go left-hand side now, Northgate trying to get themselves out of trouble. The defence holding for Glenora. They go left again, long pass out. Goes down that left-hand side. That's going to be a penalty there. That's for high. I think it was the winger that was taken there, Jordan Hart. Locke puts it into touch. A lot of pressure on Kevin Locke today. I think he's doing all the kicking and a lot of the playmaking there. So, but it's good he stuck with Northcote in that's where he started his football years ago. Down at Shepherd's Park. I remember those days. And the dummy half goes Sione Tali. Sione Tali gets out to his bigger man. Get offload there, good offload out to Locke. Locke kicks it away to his right hand side. 14 with the ball now, and it's Hiramaya. Hiramaya's going to play it. They're 15 metres out from the try line now. What can they do? Can they get to that? It was Cook put the ball out there. Goes out to Holloway, the captain of the day. He's going to play the ball there. Trying to come away with some points now. Locke with the ball outside. Off the feet there, but into Glenora player, and I think it's knocked on by. He's giving the feed to Glenora there, so, you know, the crowd on this side, they're about 130 metres away. They decide that it should have been a Northcote feed, but I think they're a little bit impartial, just fractionally. He's checked with his touch judge. I see number 12 on the paddock now. It's down as Payne, but it's not. I know him. It's David Barner, the coach. He's don't think he's pressing the panic button yet, but. Ball's in and out. Glenora come away with it now. Taken with the ball, Kingy into dummy half. Come away on that left hand side. And Fingupo out to Nathan. Nathan comes up the middle of the park and tries to straighten up. Fingupo into dummy half again. Get it out to his right hand side, and I think that's Agassia. Go away again. Fingupo making a lot of yardage out of this, the Glenora Bears. Coming away with that. It's go away now on the right hand side, and it's Chaz Brown. Wasn't him that passed the ball forward, it might have been, but you won't pick on Chaz. David Barner plays the ball, goes out to Sione Talia's dummy half, and he'll go into drag, comes into dummy half, gets it out to his right hand side to Barner. Barner gets up and plays the ball, they come right hand side. That's Cook with the ball now. Cook's taken 30 metres inside the Glenora half. Lock into half, into dummy half, gets it away to his bigger boy, the big number 16, it's Tafiti, Solomona Tafiti. And he takes it a couple of metres inside the 30 metre mark. Got to do something with it. You know, coming up half time, they need to get some points on the board. It's only a couple of three times they've been up inside the Glenora half, and that's credit to Glenora. Into dummy half goes Holloway, the captain. Goes out left-hand side to, oh, and it's nicely picked up by Nathan there. He's been a hard worker too, Nathan, for Glenora. Looks like it's Cook down here at out on the fringes. So they're playing with 12 men. It's Chaz Brown with the ball. Now the ball comes out, and it's pulled out by the referee, says the referee, by the player. Did you have a hand on it? Kicked out a few metres before the halfway line. So Chaz Brown, the Northcote need to turn around quickly. It's taken by number 12. It's Payne, Elam Payne for Glenora. He'll get up and play the ball into dummy half. Goes Vangupo. Vangupo passes it out to Tuoi. Tuoi gets it, goes and takes the tackle there. Vangupo. And you heard the voice in the background, Millie. Millie's been around for, I won't say 100 years, but she's been around a long time following Northgate. And good on her. We need supporters in the rugby league like that. And then Galton goes over, one of the easiest tries on the left-hand side with his pace. Goes over and scores 10 metres in from touch there. Puts them in the lead by 10 points to nil. So after 30 minutes gone here at Birkenhead Memorial Park in this Fox Memorial Qualifiers round two, Glenora in for their second try, and it's Galton, Anthony Galton from Glenora that scores it. And I'm pretty sure Anthony paid for Howard. I could be proved wrong later on. And the kick's going to be by Ioka. Ioka. I think I've got that right, sort of right. Hard pronunciation. The 30 minutes gone. Good Lord supporters, the Glenora and Northcote people turning up. A lot of them have been here since 11-ish. He misses a kick. Hard luck. So it's only 10 points to nil after 31 minutes gone here at Birkenhead Memorial Park. So there's hope for Northcote, yes. But they seem to, when they get into the opposition half, they sort of haven't got any attack on them, and they don't really know what they're doing. And it's quite a shame, because Northcote's had a good back line in the past, and they need to get themselves to get up. But Glenora playing really well. The defensive side of Glenora has been really good today. I don't know what happened to them last week, never mind. As Solomon said, the captain said to me before the interview, he said, I don't know what happened last week, but you know, that's footy, that's how it goes, you know. So, and I believe it was, I was going to say something about Papakura, I won't. Papakura, all of a sudden out of the blue, are coming away with a win, so we'll see how they get on today. Kevin Locke to kick the ball up, yeah, it's gone the 10 metres, and he's going to get it this time. It's going to be taken by Glenora. I think it's Chaz Brown with the ball, is it? No, it wasn't. There he is now. He'll get up and play the ball on the halfway line. They come away with the left-hand side into dummy half, comes out to Tuoi. Tuoi takes it inside the Northgate half and makes a little bit of a mistake and loses the ball there as he hit the ground there. And these players give him a tap and say, it's all right, don't worry about it, don't do it next time. That's what they should be saying. Easy to say when you're on the sideline, you'll be a sideline critic, but it is, it's a game you've got to hang on possession. Possession is 9 points of the game, so if you've got possession of the game, ball or game, you should not lose, as long as you can tackle. Comes out again to Northgate. Northgate, the young fella in there for Northgate, brings up to halfway. Comes away, we've done a 16, it's Tafiti, Solomona Tafiti. Takes it 6 metres inside the Glenora half. They take it to the left-hand side with Barnett going on to Morton. Morton takes the tackle there. The other side, they're coming out right-hand side now. The Barnett, offloads on to Latu. Latu will get up and play the ball, is it? No, it's not. It's, Holloway, the captain. Go left-hand side again to drag, puts a little chip over the top. Yeah, but it's been picked up nicely by Gorton, and Gorton will retain possession there. Goal line dropout. Must have been inside the white line, called the try line. So goal line dropout. So Northcote have a chance now of getting the ball back here and perhaps doing something with it. It'll help their supporters on this side of the park. So. That short kickoff, they take a kick, but Chaz Bam missed the tackle there, but not the next guy didn't. They come out right hand side now, in case the Barner caught with the ball, they'll be watching him, taken away by a drag. He's going to be penalised, he's on my, hold my jerseys, huh? That's what happens, it's I'm not sure, is that too away? Northgate get the penalty and come away with it. The lock out to McCarthy. McCarthy on to Hiramaya. Hiramaya takes the ball 27 metres out from the try line now. They get up and play the ball. It's McCarthy with dummy half. Goes out to big number 16. It's a Tafiti. Tafiti goes towards the line. He can't get through. It's good tackle by Fiamani. Stops the play. Holloway with the ball now. Holloway going towards the try line. And the dummy half goes to Yanitali. And they've turned around, they've been going sure in the right way. So Barner with the ball now. David Barner, the coach, player coach. We'll call him player coach today because he's normally just wants to be the coach. But he's out there to Jordan Hart. Jordan Hart takes the tackle there. Northcote need to attack. They're not very structured in there in the middle. And Barnett with the ball now. He's just going to take the ball up and steady the play down. They need to get something going now. There's 36 minutes gone. They need to come up with some points before half time. Lock with the ball. Little grubber kicks through. And it's picked up nicely by Gorton. Gorton is, gets up and he can't get out of the end goal. So he's not arguing that much. He's said fair enough. And they'll have another line dropout. So that's good play by Northgate, forcing the goal line dropout, but they need to do something more about it. They need to sort of finish off, get a try. Trailing by 10 points to nil. Oh. Jumps at the ball, but it's still drag ended up getting the ball at the back. He was a good little backup at the back. And Kevin Locke takes the ball up in the middle of the park now, and he's high tackle on Kevin Locke there. They've taken the tap. Varner runs it up. Offload out to Locke. Locke goes left, then changes his mind, goes right. Smothered by Faimani. Faimani drops him to the ground. They're under siege now. Northcote. It's his leg bone up again. Is that the hamstring? 16 with the ball. That's Tafiti. Solomona Tafiti with the ball for Northcote. And the dummy half goes the little hooker, which was Sione Tali. They go towards the line, and that's Holloway with the ball, the captain. He'll get up and play the ball. Which way are they going to go? Coming to the right-hand side with Kevin Locke. Little flick pass out to the fullback. Fullback going towards and run around his player, apparently, then. Number one, McCarthy, Hemi McCarthy. He realises and goes back, and so Glenn will come away with a penalty. 38 minutes gone, 2 minutes to go to half time. Glenn Orr leading by 10 points to nil over Northcote Tigers here at Birkenhead Warmall Park. Nice kick to the touch, 15 metres short of the halfway line for Glenn Orr. Three's got the ball, three had the ball, and Kevin Locke kept his hand around it. Number three, that was Devlin. Good Devlin. And mates, they're turning around to tap each other on the shoulder. That's good to see. And a one-on-one. Oh, no, it's 2-on-1. Some sort of exciting play, but not coming in the way of Northcote. They can't seem to get things going today. They don't even get the rub of the green. Full Kingy with the ball now. Goes out to Van Gupo. Van Gupo takes a hole through the middle of the park. He goes through over the 20-metre mark and then loses the ball. So it's a couple of times he's had it. And Van Gupo, yeah, he's got the injury to his calf muscle. Speaking of a young fella from Northgate Day, young Taylor Daniels, good little footballer on that. Said to him, why didn't he get an operation on his calf muscles? He's got calf problems. He said, I don't tell you what he said to me, but he should go and get something done because we've got some talented footballers running around in Auckland, but some of them haven't got quite that will to make it. You've got to do something about it yourself. Take the ball by the horns. So coming up to half time now, 39 minutes gone by me, he's called the time. So can Northcote hang on just for this last minute or two and go in only 10 points behind. Glenn Roar, on the other hand, will be trying to increase it. So it's not a very nice day here, a bit of rain around and, you know, but both sidelines fairly well full, and so there's a lot of people that are quite keen on their sides, the Glenora people, some Glenora colours around the park, down both sidelines, and that. So good to see. So, so you see, it's fairly full down that side, and then we go across to under the post there. They're the brave people sitting on umbrellas, and not so many, but good to see people following rugby league. That's what we're about. Great sport. And great news to have our ex-warrior coming back from rugby. Couldn't make it, well, I'd say couldn't make it in rugby, he made the All Blacks, but he's decided that league's probably his better game. He's better equipped to play rugby league, and he's got a 3-year contract with the Warriors for next season onwards, so that's nice to see. And it's nice to see the Warriors doing well too, you know, they've come up with some good wins over the last few weeks, and we've got to wait till Tuesday night to see how they get on against the feared Storm side. Now, this is one of the important games of the round. It's Australia and New Zealand, ANZAC. It's not a test match. a test to both players, those sets of players. So we're just waiting on that Van Gupo to get to the sideline. Once he makes the sideline, the referee will call time back on. So it'll be dragged to feed the scrum. So it goes out left-hand side to Locke. Looking for the inside pass, didn't get away. Got to Cook. Cook takes it out to the left-hand side, and Cook is going to be brought down 20 metres out from the try line. And Glenora penalised there for not releasing in time. Number 12 it was, Elam Payne. So Northcote come away with the ball now. That's Haku with the ball for Northcote, taking down the left-hand side. Not many minutes left in this half, so they need to do something now. Coming right-hand side now, goes out to 11, which is Kapi. Kapi, Bronson Kapi with the ball now. He's tacked flattened to the ground. Boys opposite, they come away with Barner. Barner gets it away to Tafiti, Solomon Tafiti. He get up and play the ball. Can they go right hand side again? Barner with the ball now. Offload out there. Off to the left hand side. The hood is gone. Drag with the ball. Tries a little kick. Where's the ball gone? It's going to be picked up by Phil Kingy, is it? And Phil Kingy saves the day for Glenora. And so the referee both blows the whistle for a half time. So entertaining first half. Northcote having not much luck at all and not been spending a lot of time. They've only probably been into Glenora's half by four or five times if they're lucky. But Glenora making the most of it, coming away with 10 points on the board. So that's at a half time. We'll come back after half time with Glenora leading 10 points to nil. Just awaiting Northcote and come out. The last struggling players coming out of the train dressing room. They've been in the dry. Where is that? And we'll wait for the referee's whistle to get going in the second half. And of course, Glenora leading by 10 points to nil. Kevin Locke to kick off in the second half. It's long and deep down to Phil Kingy, and he takes the ball nicely. Kavaliki takes the ball up, first hit up of the second half, way he always does. Every team needs a Kavaliki in the team, but a lot of clubs haven't got him. But, he's one of the greats around. Just steady, takes the ball up, takes the hit up. Does a good job. Nathan with the ball towards halfway now, coming up. They've got made a good 40 metres out of that. The kickoff now, the take there. Come out right hand side. Comes out to Vakai. Vakai, a basketball pass out of the top there and gets away to number 12. That's Payne, Elam Payne. Hot on attack now, Glenora, out to Kingy, Kingy out to Kavaliku again, second hit up in the set of six, he does well, doesn't he? 16 with the ball now, that's Kupu. Kupu gets it away to number 14, hanging on to the ball, nice take of the ball there, but it's the last tackle. Malachi Kupu was the one that took that ball through there, good play. Abraham Mackay. Northcote trying to run it out from their own 20 now. Come up towards the 30 metre mark. Going to make it. Just made the 20. Got away, and it's Latu with the ball. It's a Latu. Come away again. Big boy running through now. It's pulled out by the by 30, I think. Locke with the ball, kicks it into touch down that right hand side. The Makes good yardage out of that. Meters. Cook with the ball out to Lock. Getting confused. Not hard. Barner with the ball, hit up the middle there. Running into taking some of the bigger boys with him. Come away again, and McCarthy with the ball. They come away again to Barner. Barner offload again. He's been doing that when he's had it. Out to number 15. 15 with the ball now, and it's Latu. Latu with the ball. It's Rock with the ball, comes away to number 16, which is Tafiti. Tafiti takes it up, but backs into the tackle of the Glenora defence. Into dummy half goes Sianitali. Lock with the ball, grubber kicking through, but it can't go through, and comes away, and who's it with it now? They cut him off down that left-hand side. It's number 2, Whitman. Whitman's going to go. He's going to run out of steam, and he's got a couple of defensive players there that follow him all the way from about the 20-metre mark. They come out on the right-hand side. No, they don't. Somebody's in trouble there. Somebody's been sent to the bin now. It's number 9. It's Sianitali. Don't know what he did, but the referee's right on it, so must have been a professional foul. Is he gone to the bin? Not sure. Coming back now. Maybe blood bin, don't know, but it's Formani with the ball now for Glenora. King into dummy half, gets it out to Cavalucu. Cavalucu goes towards the line. Can he get over the line this time? No, he can't. It's going to be held up. So it's 11 injured for it. It's Carpi, Bronson Carpi for Northcote injured there, and one of the Glenora players went down as well, but it wasn't Cavalucu because he's a tough man. He would just run all day. They use him wisely. Yes, I'm pretty sure that, yes, we have, there's the sin bin man himself. He's in there for 10 minutes. It's Sianitali. Five minutes gone in the second half here at Birkenhead Memorial Park in this Fox Memorial Qualifiers Round 2 game. There's three rounds in this Qualifiers competition, I would say, and you need to win at least one to make sure you get through. But who knows with the draw or what, you know, if there's two teams on the one, it'll have to be the would, I presume, would go with the highest score for and against, presumably. There'll be no playoff. And that's when the reserve grade actually officially starts in 2 weeks' time, when the teams sort themselves out who's going to be in the Fox and who's going to be in the Sharman, and then they'll go to reserves for both sections of play, the Fox and the Sharman Cup. So a bit of a break here while we wait for the injured player to be repaired, or not. Number 11 is, it's Carpi, Bronson Carpi. They're taking him off. Yeah, so they've got to have another replacement. They ran short anyway, and now they'll look upon They come back into the game. They're one underway again. Glen Eye with the ball out to right side to Gordon. Gordon going towards the line. Can they stop him getting there? He's held and it's going to be a penalty. It's going to be a penalty because you see the arm go out. So he knew he was short and then he put the arm out. So it's a double movement. And the touch judge on this side, Warren Clark, very efficient touch judge and referee of many years. So Kevin Lott to take the kick. See it on replay, Phil. Right or wrong, he'll get it then. At least you'll know. Ball kicked out by Kevin Lock. See Holloway with the ball for Northcote. Comes in, the big man, the replacement player there coming in. He's knocked Mundam down, and he'll get up and play the ball. I think he's number 8, is he? It's Sione Keogh. Northcote trying to get out of their own half now. They're struggling a bit, like they were in the first half. They just sort of come to bust that line, and it's Barnard with the ball now. He offloads out there, but the man in the same position as him got the ball. Barnard with the ball now, flicks a dummy there, brings it out to his left-hand side. Still got the ability, he's got the nous to know what to do, but it's he's the coach. Drag cut inside the Glenora players there, and he gets caught on the outside there and on the over at halfway. So he's goes right hand side, goes to Lock, and Lock puts the ball into touch and the forward. His kick's just about 6 inches too long, twice now in the game. At least he can smile out of it. So 7.5 minutes gone now in this Fox qualifying game. The leaders at the moment is Glenora. Kavaliku takes the ball up inside the 40 now for Glenora. It comes out right hand side. Bring it out to Brown. Brown gets it out to the winger to Varkey. Varkey, yeah, takes it towards the line. He's brought down. In the dummy half goes Chaz Brown. Followed up. Good play by Chaz. He's going for the try. That's what he's there for. He wanted to get the ball from dummy half and go for it. Comes out left-hand side. Long play out to number 6. It's there to Okay. Gets it out to Kavaliku. Kavaliku going towards the line. He throws the inside pass or outside pass. Don't know. But it's going back. It's going back for a late tackle, it looks like, on Drag, Nico Drag. So they'll get the penalty, I'm pretty sure. Another injury break. Drag is down. Glenora's got the ball, so it looks like it could be... Can't be a late tackle on Glenora because they had the ball. Never mind. We'll see you in a minute. They'll come back and send us note. Make a noise, Charlie! And there's our Millie. Oh, not our Millie. Yes, it is our Millie because she's a... She follows football, she follows the Tigers, but she follows footy as well. So good to see, and that's what she likes. Need more people like her following the game. And just like a little chat in between times now, you're just looking at the referee there, you know. I know that the referees are really struggling for numbers, and if there's any ex-players out there that really, you know, go along to the referees, get in touch with Pete Filman, get in touch with the Auckland Rugby League or the Referees Association and say you'd like to referee, give it a go. And it's like anything, give it a go. If you're too old to play, get out and go and referee a game or two and see how you like. It's just the same as running with the ball, but you haven't got the ball in your hands, and you don't have to take the tackles and get hurt. So it's a good plug for the Referees Association in Auckland, and Auckland Rugby League are right behind the Referees Association, I believe. So, just by the way. So we're still waiting now for this injury on that drag. And we're waiting to see what the penalty is for. I thought it was the penalty of a late penalty, late tackle on drag, but maybe it wasn't. It's a hole back by Northgate. So we're back into it now. Man number 12 comes in, a Payne, Elam Payne going towards the try line now. 16 into dummy half is Kupu. Kupu gets it out to his left hand side, and Valk Kavaluku goes through. He's dying to score a try, and he deserves a try too. The work he's done, he's done a lot of hard work up the middle, and in a couple of plays it's been two hit ups in a set of six. So good play up, get it out to the right hand side, comes out to Phil Kingy. Little pass out to Nathan, and Brown offloads it out to Vaki, and Vaki scores the try in the right-hand corner. So Glenora get away again after 9.5 minutes in the second half and score their third try of the game. I think that went to is it Wickman? Not sure. Floated by Chaz Brown, pretty unselfishly.
Involved like that one earlier here before with your guys was definitely an obstruction. I've got to be able to see it and call it. I'll keep an eye out for it.
So we've had the referees turn down for the second half. I turned it down at half time so I could hear them having their private chat on the sideline that well, they're having drinks break. So.
Thank you, sir.
I'll turn him back on now so we can hear him.
Cheers. You got it, Chaz.
So maybe it's number 5 that scored that try, Varkey, John Varkey. Chaz Brown to attempt their conversion from wide out. 6 inches from touch. If you're dealing in inches, I am. Been doing a bit of bodybuilding on Chaz, but must help his football. Comes in, kicks now, looking pretty good. No, put the weight to the right hand side, getting a bit of stick from the sideline there. And his captain, who's injured at the moment, Solomon. So Glenroy leading by 14 points to nil after half time, 12 minutes into the second half.
Time you're on! On you, Nolly. We're good. Gontin, play on! No, play on!
Number 5 takes it, the try scorer.
Together.
Takes it 8 metres short of the halfway line into dummy half. No goes Kupu. Kupu gets it out to Vike
McCoy. Morgan! Yes, sir.
Silly boy flopping in. Call from the touch judge there. Hasn't got much to say in the game, but he did say it then. Oh, okay, kick the ball into touch and makes good yardage out of that. He meant 25 metres.
Wait for the tap.
It's 3 with the ball. Devlin gets it out to Kingy. Kingy on to
contact's good.
Faramani goes in with the ball towards the 3 metre mark.
You're good, you're good. No! Go one.
And Manny trying to draw a penalty that way this time because he has to fill Kingy. Kingy throws the dummy pass, gets it away, gets it to the right hand side to Brown. Brown takes it up the middle. Brown's going to go. He goes, flicks it onto his winger there to Varkey. And comes with Northcote. Northcote knocked it on.
Sorry? Play the ball, marker. Play the ball. Ball's gone out. Their ball, come off Northcote. When he's offloaded, it's come off your guy.
14 will play the ball, that's Mackay.
Can you just look for an inside ear, inside shoulder?
Away they go there, and it's Nathan with the ball now, number 13. Gets out of one, can't get out of the second tackle.
Hey,
and he's going to be brought down 10 metres short of the try line now.
You're good, you're good. Hold. Go one.
Cooper into dummy half, gets it out to Ioka. Ioka out Payne, and Payne unselfishly passes out to number 5 to Varkey, John Varkey, and John Varkey goes over for his second try of the game. So puts themselves in front by 18 points to nil after 14 minutes gone this second half. So not good for Northcote, but Glenora backing each other up.
Yeah, yeah.
And then we're fucked.
Yeah, yeah, no. You know what I mean? Yeah. But
they said,
but that block runner, he was fine. He's then cleaned out and the pole's gone out, okay? Yeah. I said, there was nothing wrong with that one at all.
That.
Yeah, yeah. I appreciate it. I've asked the touchy myself to keep an eye out for you.
Kevin Locke getting a little bit frustrated there and speaking nicely to the referee and what you got to do and be Ioka to attempt the conversion. Kick, he missed the, oh, he didn't miss the last one. Chase Brown did. Should have left it to...
I'm going to go to a couple of rucks because there's some niggas in there.
Comes in and kicks. Down the middle it goes. 18 becomes 20. So Glenora leading by 20 points to nil over Northcote in this Fox Memorial Qualifiers Round 2 game. So unless something happens drastically for Northcote, they will come away with another loss and be looking in the barrel next week of playing, not sure who they're playing next week. I know Glenora's got Maris, so they could go ahead or may not. It's game of footy, who knows. Give them a lot to kick off for Northcote.
Time you run!
We're good. Kevin Locke going for the high kick as well again. Ball comes down and nicely taken by number one, McCarthy.
No, penalty. He played it in front of the line.
It goes over the line.
It never came back. He played it before the line. His ass was over the line, but the ball never was.
No, but you'll have to look at the replay after. I can't show you it now. But the referee ruling that he... took the ball inside the 10, not outside the 10, which you must take it outside the 10. The ball's got to be allowed to travel 10 metres.
Yeah.
Stopped it from travelling that 10 metres and get the penalty against them.
Hold, play on.
Devlin to take the ball for the tap. Kavaliku takes the first hit up on this set of six.
Move!
See how many more hit ups he does in this set of six.
He does
one or two. It comes away left hand, right hand side to Nathan. Nathan gets it away to Ioka.
No, he ran behind two players and then come back.
He ran behind two players and came back. So therefore, it's an obstruction.
Hang on, boys. He's in my way. I can't continue, boys. Go sideways, brother. Thank you.
So Northcote get the penalty. Kevin Locke to kick it out. And does so.
You're on here 14. On here 40. Up with me, boys.
Holloway with the ball now for Northcote. Takes it up to the...
hands up now!
Mark.
12 hold. Go one. Contact's good.
Number 8 with the ball now for Northcote.
Get in off the ball!
Okay, good run of the ball when he hangs on to it.
Get in, I gave you a direct command and you don't get to work him over. Second effort. Yeah. No, but it wasn't a held up one. It wasn't like when you're sitting there stationary and coming in on a cannonball.
Lock takes the ball to touch.
On the line, on the line.
That's a good 17, 18 metres.
Yes.
Haku with the ball, takes a tap. Holloway, Holloway gets it out to Barner. Barner takes it up the middle of the
pack. Ho, ho, ho! Release! No one.
And gets it to the right-hand side there. They go out to number 10 coming through. And that's...
Move! Together!
Tafferty. Tafferty will take the ball. He's got up and plays the ball. Comes out inside past the lock. Barner goes towards the line. Barner goes towards the line. Can he make it? Is he there? Referee's right there and he says, yes, he got the try down. So David Barner, the retired coach, retired player coach, has gone over the line to the left-hand side of the uprights there and scored a good forwards try. So hopefully that will inspire the rest of the forwards to sort of play like he's playing at the moment, you know. It's good to get points on the board. That's what it's all about. So good try by David Barner. Yeah. 90 minutes gone this second half. Three quarters of the way through the game. It's locked to take a quick kick at goal there, conversion, to make sure they get a bit more time.
Lee, if we could get a time kick from the
batsman
before us, please. If we could get a time kick from the batsman before us.
So North got in with their first points of the game, and in the second half is by David Barner, converted by Kevin Locke. So 20 points to 6. The wayside Glenora leading over Northcote. Now they wouldn't be.
22 to go.
Good T-boy there, that's the captain of the actual captain of the team, that's Solomon.
Time you're up!
Heading for the game, very well spoken football player. Ball long, deep into the half, and Locke brings it wide to the fullback to McCarthy. McCarthy tries to straighten up and...
Hey! Stand now! Get square! Hold! Go away!
Come left again and it's Keogh. With a ball, the big number
8. 16, release! Oh!
They go left hand side again, inside pass to.
Off the legs, move 16!
Cappy, oh. Cappy will get up and play the ball.
Go through.
Tafiti, sorry. Goes away, left hand side, Holloway with the ball now. Captain of the side, he's got to be brought down.
15, stand now!
Short of the halfway line.
It's 4, go 4.
Go right hand side.
12, release!
Tafiti with the ball now. He takes a tackle, gets it, and plays the ball. Kevin Locke putting it high up in the air. Some of the players in front there.
Touch, not
play. Gorton comes away with it for Glenora. Comes away left hand side there, so nobody put everybody out inside.
7, hands off!
Glenora now,
and take it back.
Coming.
Yep, go to.
So he takes it back to a couple of inches. So Nathan with the ball, gets it away to his right inside. Comes out to the right, goes out to Chaz Brown. Chaz Brown pushes off one, trying to push off another two. Comes away again, strong run of the ball. He's going to take the tackle there. He's not going to get up and get exconded. Oh, he's got cramp. Fitness pick.
That's 3! Go through!
It's 12 on inside pass to Gorton. Gorton goes away. You're not going to stop him. He's a real, real speedster.
Good grounding.
Anthony Gorton. And he comes away in his right hand side, takes that pass nice and easy, and scores to the midway, the post, and the corner flag. So a nice try scored by. Glenora after the Chaz Brown, I was going to say imitation, but it's not imitation. He's stretching his hamstring there. But, so they score. They take them out to 24 points to 6 to Glenora over Northcote in this Fox Memorial Qualifiers Round 2 game. So waiting for a kicker. We're in time called out.
Yes.
Araka to take the kick.
Come out to me, please, brother.
One.
Thank you, sir.
Six to kick to attempt this conversion. Out to the right hand side of the post there, comes in.
And where are we?
No, no wind now, the wind has dropped, so out to the right hand side, so 24 becomes 24. 24 points to 6, not 26.
Yep.
23 and a half minutes gone in this Fox Mulgrew game here. So it'd be Northcote to kick from south to west. Actually, south to east. South to north. It'd be Kevin Locke again. He'll kick it high and long again.
Play on.
Who's got the ball? Who wants it?
No. Knock on. No, the first man touched it, then the second guy's gone. You promoted the ball this way. Knock on.
Scrum.
Knock on. The first person comes and tapped it in the air just because he's gone past and he's pulled it forward, then the second guy's got it, but the ball's gone forward. Knock on.
Got to remember, players. Oh, the referee's sorry. Always right.
One more. Or have you still got someone off?
It could have gone either way then. You know, I have to watch the replay as to what happens. I thought it came off a shoulder of the Northcote player, but never mind. It's a call's been called, and he is against Northcote. And it just seems that all the penalties have actually gone against Northcote. That's the way it is at the moment. If you have a bad day, That's
Man.
That's a my.
Give space! Go to.
And there with the white hair there. And who, dummy heart.
Hands up, Morgan!
Funny map.
Go three.
Find Marnie, get the ball that way. Comes out. Going out to Nathan. Nathan takes it up to the 30 inside Northcote's half. They'll have to get off quickly there.
Go four.
Come away with number 12. And number 12 cuts a hole there. Gets on to number 6 to Ioka. Ioka goes in the left hand side of the post and gets another try, the fourth try of the second half. Fourth try of the second half, so it's Ioka. Sorry. Getting a bit tongue tied there. Things happening pretty quick around here. So another try to number 6.
No,
he scored the first try and he's got the last one at the moment. And after 25 minutes gone in this second half of this Fox qualifier game. So it looks like Northcote.
Oh,
hate to say it, but
it
looks like Northcote will have to be the drawing board for next week's game. Whoever they've got, they need to win and put on a few points. Win well.
Away.
Kicked it away to the right hand side of the post, and looking by the expression on his face, he's a bit disappointed what he did then. But never mind, that's what happens. Sometimes it doesn't go exactly right. Points to 6 at Birkenhead Memorial Park. Glenora, the scoreboard's lost the plot. They're not quite sure. Here we go, but 20's going up. Probably as long as they put an 8 up there, it'll be right. Yeah, he's got it right now. So Kevin Locke to kick off for Northcote now.
We're good.
On the ground this time, gets a bounce and it's Amai. Amai spills the ball out.
Play on!
Come away with the ball and it's big number 10 with it. Tafiti takes it up the middle of the park and he's going to be
down
on the 30 metre inside Glenora half. Here they come with big number 8. Can he hang on to the ball? Run by him. That's Kyo.
Go one.
They go right. Go to Kevin Locke, dummies left, dummies to right, and then he dummies left. goes ahead, takes the tackle there on the inside the 20 there. Big number 8, Rio, comes into the ball now. Glenora leaving early, so referee Newton right on the ball.
No, no, you boys are all right. It was here, off early. No, no, 13, brother. You're
Nathan, cool his name. Hell no.
Just hold.
Another cramp. And I didn't think we stopped him cramp. Not supposed to.
You can be anywhere.
It's not nice to get a cheer of that, you know. But
he's got to doing a spastic in front of our.
No, and he's called time out because it's where the position
time's
is
off,
in.
Boys, time's
so,
off.
You know.
Gentlemen's in our way.
So 28 and a half minutes gone in the second half here. Northcote on attack. Can they do something with it? Big number 10, that's Tafiti. Tafiti comes in with the ball, going towards the back.
Get it. Play the ball!
Get it. Comes away to the left-hand side. Northcote, long wide pass out to, goes out to number 5, to Talakai. Talakai gets up and plays the ball. Goes to the right-hand side. Goes into number 4, to Haku. Haku takes the ball forward.
13, 6, move!
It's the only tally into dummy half.
Oh, go through.
Can they come away with some good stuff? 13 with the boys. Holloway, the captain, setting by example, going towards the try line. They get it right outside. Not sure about it. Kevin Locke plays the outside pass to a little winger out there. And touch. No, they can't get him to touch now. Northcote still in possession of the ball. Locke takes the ball. He put a little kick over the top, and it's going to be taken by Gordon. Gordon takes the catch in the in-goal area, and he taps and goes. And he's that much speed on his both legs that if he gets a half break, you won't catch him. Comes away to the right-hand side to Varkey. Varkey takes it towards the halfway. He's about 3 metres short of the halfway line now. And the dummy half goes... Kupu gets it out to his left-hand side to Amai.
Get in, move! You good here, boys?
He gets up, plays the ball, comes away to the right-hand side, goes out to Agatia. Agatia takes it inside the 40 in the north third half. They come away to the left-hand side to Phil Kingy. Phil Kingy put the little quick through, and it's and he nearly missed the ball in there, knocked it forward in the air, but regardless... Gets the commentator a bit excited there. Northcote trying to bring it out with the fellas. I think that's McCarthy trying to bring it out there. No, that's McCarthy in the arc. Gets away to the winger there. It's Jordan Hart.
15! Hold.
You get up and play the ball. Into dummy half goes Locke. Locke gets it away to Cook.
Move now!
Mody Cook will get up and play the ball. Comes right again. Kevin Locke, a little trick through, Can they get the thing? No, but a good tackle by number 6. A little standoff, drag for Northcote. Good kick and chase there. Now it's back to Gordon. Gordon's going to be penalised high there.
Yeah, I know he's going down. That's why it's only a penalty. I know there was an intent in there. He was going down. Hang on, no. We've got players out the back, all sorts of things. So I give you guys the same privilege. All right, they're going back. Are you kicking? Oh, hang on, you got freaking... You all right to go without him? Or are you on attack? Where you go.
Long kick down that right-hand side, and it's...
On the 10, on the 10!
Over Talakai's head there, so he couldn't get up and get it. And Brown with the ball, no. He will take the tap.
Play for the tap! On you, Chaz, yes.
Goes with number 12, Papaini Limpain, going to the line now.
Oh, go on.
There we go, down this right-hand side. Chaz Brown says this, I can get through there. And he's over, he twists and turns and gets over and scores a try. So Chaz Brown in for... Try number 1. So Chaz Brown eventually gets over in the 32nd minute, scores his first try of the game.
Oh,
He's had a kick at goal and missed, and he's had a try now and got it. So here we go, 32 minutes gone. And this second half takes him out to 32 points to 6 lead. And it'll be Ioka.
No, he was falling dead.
Ioka to take the kick, so...
I think we're probably about 12 minutes, but if you check with a nice lady in the tent, you'll confirm, but it'll be about that.
Jess Brown,
time left?
Hobbling a lot. He's got his trike, and
I don't mean to be.
He might be saying, I can go off.
Your refreshment replenishment time.
So I go to attempt this conversion, and looking at that, going down right down the middle there. Nice kick by Koye Ioka. I think I hope I got that right. Some 34-6 to Glenora here on their way to stay in the Fox. And Northcote, they're not heading that way at the moment. There's another game to go, so who knows who they're playing, I'm not sure. Kevin up to kick off just from the southern end. Again, going high.
Play on.
No, Nathan takes the ball nicely this time.
Glenora.
The dummy half goes Kupu.
Kupu
feeds the ball out to Vaki. Vaki goes caught short of the halfway line there. So Kupu goes in dummy half again. Yeah, he said, I like this position. Goes out. Big number 8 comes through. Agati.
Hands off.
Agati
coming on my left.
Takes
on my
it 7 metres inside the... Northcote half out to Tuoi. Tuoi takes
Boom!
It up.
Now!
He's 31 metres out from the line now. They go to the left hand side now. Going down left, a little grubber kick through. Not yes, picked up by
Amai. Knock on.
Knock on, calls the referee. So he did say it.
Now, thank you for asking. I brought it off you, boss. Scrum here, Northcote.
So knock on there. So about 5-6 minutes left in this half. A few injury breaks in the second half, and of course, early season, this is what happens. Players are come along not as fit as they probably should be. And I know that the coach at Northcote is saying that. It's the players are coming along, they're unfit. And the dedication that he requires for them, so it's a bit of a shame. I think they've lost Trent Shomko because of that reason. So, it's all about player attitude. Want to come and play properly. You know, so it's player on, calls the referee. It's easy now. It's Jordan Hart with the ball. Goes up, beats a couple, and then can't beat those two. They're bigger than him. He'd make quarter the size of those two to get all together. Holloway with the ball now. Comes away. Comes up to the 27-metre mark in their own half now.
Thank you.
Northcote struggling to get some ascendancy across the board here. Coming through, big number 8, Pini Keo. Gets the ball out 12 metres short of the halfway line. That's a good little run by him. He's put some effort into it. Kevin Locke puts the ball in and inside the 40, and it's outside the 20. So it's a play the ball.
Hey, you use the line. David, you have the mark. Play the ball. Glenora.
So Glenora get the handover there. Kevin Locke, a little bit short, 10 metres short of that 40-20.
Okay.
Some of the players struggling to get back inside again now, so both sides are struggling.
Move! Now! Go one.
Ball comes away from Kupu to his mate outside. He'll get up and play the ball. It's a
go to.
I got it. Brown goes through, they'll try and push him into touch, but that's a little bit heavy to carry, quite strong. So, Gordon gets it out the left-hand side, goes out to Payne. Payne straightens up and he goes down the back row. We have a player down for Northgate with cramp. Goes again with Nathan. Nathan gets a short little pass to Oi, and a short little pass was forward. So referee on the ball there. So So another stoppage in play. I made it 3 minutes ago with my stopwatch, but there's been a few stoppages in the second half, and a lot of it is cramping.
Penalty! 13, don't call my integrity, no. Yeah, don't call the tip going like that. Hold up, time's off.
Somewhere a bit
of... He's sitting there having a go at the touch judge saying, wipe your eyes. So if he wants to do that, hold up, I've called time off because you've got a man out the back.
He's talking to his teammate.
It was a Nathan, was it? Called the touch judge, take and wipe his eye. You can't say that. You must not pick on the referees or their touch judges. There's the penalty for a back chat by hey, number 13, Nathan. So,
on you when you're ready.
Ball kicked into touch over that right hand side inside the Genoa half.
Yeah, yeah.
So can Northcote come away with some...
Yeah, he's not leaving the field, he's offside, that's fine.
You've got a player in front, you've got a player in front.
Time's on, it's working in your favour at the moment.
We go with it, number 16 comes away with it. It's Tafiti, Solomona Tafiti, and he's brought down 11 metres inside the Genoa half. They come away again, going this left-hand side again, lock out to... They need the bounce of the ball here. They need the bounce of the ball. Who's going to get it? He's got it.
The fire pillar.
The ball.
Move! Oh, go one.
Ball boys in my road anyway. So little number five going down that left hand charge. Have a go. Talakai.
Go two.
Goes out to Drake out to Locke. Locke cuts inside. Cutting across the face of his own players there. Gets it away to. Jordan Hart with the ball now. Three. He'll play it short of the line now. Kevin Locke, can he get number five in? And number five reaches out and scores a try. So all thanks to Kevin Locke. He got number five, little number five, Talakai to Albert Talakai to score a try on this left-hand side. So looking after each other. So that's good play by Kevin Locke out to Talakai to score the try. So another 4 points on the board for Northcote. So they're not scoreless, I'll say. Number five.
About five to go, roughly.
So I'm making about 3 minutes to go. Three or four or five minutes to go. Nat, and a little bit of
get over yourself.
Respect. Try scorer.
He hasn't been on that long, he shouldn't be cramping yet. Thank you.
So Kevin Locke to Kevin Locke to attempt this conversion from a bit wide out. Comes in and kicks. Inside the flag, inside the post it goes. So Kevin Locks puts another 2 points on the board for Northcote. Bit of respectability there.
Hit.
So they go with that kick.
Sorry, thank you.
That's Kevin Locks. That's 12. Two tries, two conversions for them, but they're trailing by 34 points to 12 now with only 2 or 3 minutes to go.
1 minute, bro.
Whatever.
Yes, sir. Time you run! Yes. We're good.
Come away now, the big boy coming up the middle. That's similar. 8 is Kyle, is it? That's 16. Tafiti with a big hit up there. Nice big hit up to finish the game off there. Comes away to Holloway, the captain. Captain coming up, and he's 22 metres short of the halfway line now.
Don't go early, hold, go through.
Come left hand side with big number 8 coming through. That's
Release quickly! On my left!
Get up, play the ball.
No, faster, he earned the right.
No, penalised there again. Nathan penalised for holding down.
Yes, where you are.
Kevin Locke kicks it into touch. One play! It's a hooter, guys, but the one play says the referee, so they're going to do something.
One
what
play!
What are they going to do? Kevin Rocker trying to trick all the players. He's going to try a tricky little bounce. He needs to bounce the ball. Bounce the ball goes to five. Gets a ball, and now he's put into touch. As he goes into touch, he throws the ball backwards, but that's it. He couldn't do much about that. It was a nice little play by Kevin Locke. Yeah, off the side of the foot there, bouncing through, and the winger going down, number five, managed to get it and couldn't get to the... hang on to the ball and get past the defending player. So there we have it. It's sort of entertaining game here at Birkenhead Warmer Park in this Fox Memorial Qualifiers Round 2 game. Glenora is safely now winning one game today with 34 points and Northgate with 12 points. So 34-12 to Glenora in this Fox Memorial Qualifiers Round 2 game. Next week is the third game of the round, and that's when all the decisions are made. So that's it from Birkenhead Memorial Park at this stage. Yes, I have Kevin Locke, the well-represented world traveller here with me, the number 7 halfback for Northgate. Just ask Kevin about the game. Unlucky, they come away by 34 points to 12, but there's some signs of good stuff by you guys.
Yeah, we sort of like went off last week. Our defence was a bit poor around the middle, and I thought that the boys in the first half certainly made a difference. We muscled up, we were staying in the grind, and we just sort of fell off in that second half, which was disappointing.
Yeah, it is disappointing. Yeah, and disappointing for you, because I know you've lost a lot of players this season, gone to other clubs or gone overseas and that, and makes it very hard to keep going, but then having the poor old coach have to play, Was it wise he played, or was he better off on the sideline? Be honest.
No, it is wise that he plays. He has a lot of experience. He's a coach for a reason, and for him to be able to come out and play certainly helps the fellas that are unaware of the game and sort of unfamiliar with the game, which we have a few rugby boys that's their first time playing. So, you sort of got to give it to the efforts of them giving it a go.
Yeah.
Still a lot of work to be done. It's always back to the drawing board.
Back to the drawing board, that's
and,
right.
And, just trying to teach them. And, everyone's always learning. And if the likes like myself and Davey and Morgan can help those guys, then it certainly, will help the team.
That's really good, Kevin, So you've still got a game to go. Do you know who you got next week?
Yeah, we got Papakura.
You got Papakura next week. Yeah, and Papakura, a funny side, because they've got... come away with some money. Oh no, I shouldn't say that, but they've obviously bought some players on that, and they're playing quite well. So, yep, you can step up next week and beat Papakura. That'd be really good for the competition, wouldn't it?
Oh, definitely. We know it's going to be a tough game.
Yeah.
We knew that the competition's always going to be tough. That's just the nature of Fox, I guess. But I guess we just got to focus on week by week now, and it's just more... just trying to develop us as a club and as a team. So, if we can do that, I guess, we can put smiles on the faces. I guess it's going to be unfortunate that we're probably not going to make the Fox. And that's the reality of it. But we can focus on the second part, and which is what we did last year. So, if we can, we got a little bit of joy out of that. And even though we played in the bottom section, we still got a bit of joy out of it, and there's a bit of happiness at the club. So if we can sort of go in the mentality to do the same thing, it's just a bit of an unfortunate start for us, and we just got to focus on what's
forward.
Yeah, exactly.
Nothing we can do about it. Well, thank you, Kevin, for coming across, for spending your time with us now, and I'll let you go and have
pleasure,
a shower.
Pleasure, always good catching up with you, mate.
I just remember the days when you were 5 years old, playing down at
Shepherd's Park.
So it's good to see you again, Kevin.
No, you're a legend, Pete.
Thank you, mate.
Cheers, mate.
Thanks for coming.
See you again soon.
Shall do. That was Kevin Locke, the halfback from Northcote, and very, very wise words, very good, loyal Northcote man coming to be sensible about what is happening to them, and by losing, maybe that's going to put them down in that Sharman Cup, but they wanted to rebuild the club, and that's really good. So that's it from Birkenhead Warmer Park. Peter Bogue of Pete's Filming, wishing you a very good afternoon and a safe drive home.